Good afternoon, friends. My today's presentation topic is emotional quotient in sense and sensibility. Emotional quotient and emotional intelligence are the similar words that can be used parallelly. And according to Wikipedia, they are giving this kind of definition that it is the capability of individuals to recognize their own emotions and those of others, discern between different feelings and label them appropriately. Use emotional information to guide thinking and behavior, and manage and or adjust emotion to adapt to environments or achieve one's goals. So the emotional intelligence, and we will try to say see that some of the characters are emotional intelligence, how they are using, and how Jane Austen has created that emotional intelligence and the use of them. So according to Bhagavad Gita, how emotional intelligence can be interpreted in through various forms. So in our Hindu scriptures also, emotional intelligence can be interpreted like this. So the one who is able to control the emotions in all the situations is called balance. And the Sanskrit slok of that, the second chapter, and the slok number 56 is that Dukheshvanu Dhamanaha Sukheshu Vigastruhava Vitarag Bhaya Krodha Stita Dhir Muni Ruchyate. And we will see that Eleanor, Marianne, and Willoughby are how portrayed as emotional intelligence, and how we can read that. So Eleanor in the novel represents sense, and Marianne represents sensibility. So making mistakes and taking false decisions in emotional turmoil is generally led by catastrophe like breakdown. We can see that there are so many situations in our life that we all of a sudden confused that what decisions we need to take, or to what conclusion we have to jump to. So that thing, it is reflected here, and both sense and sensibility are supplementary to each other. And sense and sensibility are both necessary in human life, but we have to make very fine balance between both the things. So Willoughby represents today's materialistic culture. We can see that Willoughby betrays Marianne, and how he betrays her and goes to another woman for just materialistic purpose and property only. And how the novel can be read today? If we try to locate this novel in our current situation and modern times, it can be read like multifaceted diamonds. The other day we were looking at unconscious biases, that how to remove our unconscious bias. So we have to look at any problem with multidisciplinary way, or we have to look at the problem just like a diamond. So Marianne Dashwood as an example of reluctance and impatience. Marianne Dashwood is portrayed as very reluctant, is very eager to do everything, is very hesitant in all those things, and taking decisions is also lacking in her qualities. And novel as a lesson to youth, one should be careful in decision making. So after reading the entire novel, youth can take very good message from this novel that we should not jump to any conclusion just by looking anybody's outward appearances. We have to look deeper, think critically, and we have to look so many different aspects of everything, and then we should make anything clear. The complexity in life, the character of Willoughby, John Willoughby, portrays that can be looked at as the representation of today's material life. John Willoughby is only interested in materialistic things and property, and the one who is getting inheritance, so he will go there, and he will marry that lady only, and he will court that person only. And materialistic life makes people monotonous and ignorant by emotional grounds. So after making that materialistic life at our habit, so once it becomes our habit, our emotional grounds become very much ignorant, and we become very less careful about those things. And the other day we are seeing that people are joining the rat race of wealth and power, shallowness in emotional intelligence, and both the things we can see here. And there are three E's that is very important in to maintain emotional intelligence and balance. That education, and it is required to develop critical thinking. We have to read a lot. We have to look so many things with different angles. And then this helps in making choices and decisions. If we look at things with only one thing, that will not help. So the other thing is environment. It helps us to sustain various hardships, such as Eleanor's company gives motivation to Marianne's, and vice versa. To what to what environment we are reflecting and to which people we are interacting, that becomes very important as far as environment aspect is concerned. Who are we talking to whom we are being with, or how the conversation goes on with our day-to-day life, that makes a very big impact. And the other is experience. Marianne, after hurdles and heartbreak, gets to know that both sense and sensibility should be balanced. Marianne once experienced that very bad experience of heartbreak is there. So when John Willoughby leaves Marianne, she gets to know that how sense and sensibility should be there and how I need to think very critically about before taking any kind of decision. So that balance, that very important thing is necessary. So love at first sight. The problem with Marianne's heartbreak is love at first sight. John Willoughby takes benefit of her innocence and plays with her emotions, though he never loved Marianne truly. So Eleanor's delay in revealing the feelings of Edward can be seen as balanced attitude towards emotional matters. So in front of, as far as Marianne's character is concerned, if we try to locate Eleanor's character, such as her sister, so she delays to reveal all the things to Edward's parents. We know that. And her attitude is very balanced towards everything. She takes very ample time to reveal everything to anybody. So that balanced manner, that emotional matters is very necessary. And it is all about practicing empathy. We need to locate ourselves through others' perspective, and then we can connect ourselves with other problems, and then we can make any decision very strong. So, incident of death of Sardar Patel's wife, that I need to explore at some extent, that when Sardar Patel was inside the court and her wife was hospitalized, and somebody came to the court and handed him a sheet of paper and handed that his wife is now no more. So his presence of mind and stability are such remarkable thing that he just folded out that sheet of paper and pocketed inside and then went away from that entire case. And he won the case actually. And then he revealed the truth that his wife is now no more. So such balance, attitude and presence of mind is necessary in everybody's life. And then if we try to locate the story with the novel story, with the emotional intelligence aspect, the story would be like this, and it would be twisted. Marianne would have saved from the heartbreak if she could have cultivated critical thinking about John Willoughby. She might have thought that John Willoughby is all of a sudden being very nice to me, and how he is able to court me in all the manner. She should have think critically. And if she could have think and checked everything on that background, what is behind John Willoughby's behavior, that she might have done this. So John Willoughby also would have found Marianne's love worthier than wealth. If John Willoughby would have practiced empathy and tried to see that how emotional intelligence works, so he might have seen that Marianne's love is worthier than wealth. That he is running behind all those wealth and property, he could have changed that attitude also. The Edward Ferrars also would have revealed his hidden relationship with Lucy Steele. Edward Ferrars is also keeping secret with everybody throughout the novel. So with hidden relationship with Lucy Steele, and could have transparency with Eleanor's strategy. She could have been, he could have been more clear about all those things, and he might have taken ample time to reveal those things also. And these are the works I have cited from different sources. And thank you.